Hey everyone! So today's video is going to be a little bit different from what I usually do. I'm going to be doing a question and answer video because a few people sent in some questions and I thought it would be fun for you to watch Yodel play in his little playpen. This is actually my parents' whirlpool tub, so it makes a really good playpen. So I put him in there and I will answer your questions as best as I can. Okay, so our first two questions are by the lovely Chocolate Colors 26, and she asked, if you could have any animal in the world, what would it be? Well, surprisingly, I don't have any outrageous or weird animals on my list, not like a purple hippo or flying unicorn, although a unicorn would be like super awesome to have. I would say probably a dachshund. I used to have one, as you all know, her name was Tootsie Roll. And she was so much fun and so cute, and dachshunds just have this thing about them that, no offense, but I don't think other dogs have what dachshunds have, so yeah, I definitely would probably say a dachshund, along with two hamsters, one or two hamsters, of course, obviously. Okay, second question, how did you get into hamsters? Well, my first hamster was actually more so my brother's. I was 10 and he was 12 and we shared him. His name was S'mores and he was a banded cream Syrian hamster and he was super fluffy. We got him from my brother's school friend who they had two hamsters that had babies, and I know you guys are like all against breeding and stuff, and I am too, but they would breed them occasionally and give them away to friends, so we ended up getting one and he was really cute. He lived in like those really old hearts cages that had all kinds of tubes and stuff, and looking back on it, obviously it was still too small, but he seemed like a happy hamster. So that was the first one I had, but I would say the one that actually got my like hamster addiction started was Cream Puff, and she was the first hamster I got when I was on a hamster hideout. So yep, and the rest is history. Okay, our next questions come from Creative Hamster, and she is super creative, by the way. She makes the neatest graphics. She asked, what is Yodel's diet like? I haven't honestly found a food that I really like for hamsters. I tend to do a lot of mixing and changing every so often. Like, I'll buy a couple of brands to use, then I'll switch it up and get something else. Typically, Missouri pellets are the staple, and then Hazel Hamster or Hearts Bonanza and Carefresh Complete. So typically there's about three different brands that I mix together, and then I add a lot of add-ins because I like variety and I think variety is good. So I do things like dry cereal flakes, oats, wheat germ, flax seeds, sesame seeds, occasionally a lentil or two, and yeah, he doesn't really like millet, so that's about it for dry food. For wet food, he gets three or four different varieties each day. Like, I'll give him a little piece of broccoli, a piece of, say, kale, and then maybe an apple slice. And then I try and give him some sort of protein along with that, like a little piece of chicken or cheese. And then sometimes I'll give him a little piece of pasta or bread, which he really likes that too. It sounds a little bit complicated. It's actually not that hard, because once you have a whole bunch of hamsters, you get to know, you know, rough estimates as far as how much to give them and what to give them, so it's really not difficult at all. He's not really a food-motivated hamster. He's like the least food-motivated hamster I've ever had. Like, you can just put something there. As you can see, I have his dish, and I have, like, a piece of cucumber on that little wooden ramp, and, he's just like, eh, I'd rather run around and play. So that's kind of cute. Okay, let's see. What is your daily routine with Yodel? I don't actually have a set routine. I just go by Yodel's routine, like whenever he wakes up and when he wants to come out and such. I typically spot clean every other day and straighten his toys. Yodel, what are you doing? He's chewing in the tube. Yeah, so typically I spot clean and straighten his toys, and then like every couple of days I'll change the toys out so he doesn't get bored. Okay, Yodel.
Hey. Hey. Don't you. Come on. Look.
Oh, look at that. He's taking the cucumber.
Come on.
And I'm just going to take that tube out so he doesn't chew it. Yep.
Watch out. You're so silly now, Yodel.
Okay, let's see. Where were we? Daily routine. Yeah. Okay, so that's about it. These next two questions are from Syrian Cole 526, and Cole is his hamster, who is super adorable, by the way. And I will be doing a shout out to him in the next video, probably. So, yep. Okay, he asks, what is your cage cleaning plan, and how often do you do a full change? What do you use to clean, etc.? Okay, as you guys know, Yodel has the big DIY wooden cage, and then he has the oboes attached. Depending how, like, naughty he is, sometimes he gets really naughty and he just will, like, chew, and it drives me nuts. So I, like, detach the tube for that, and then he stays in the DIY cage for a few days until he comes down. But typically, I definitely do not clean it all at once. That would be a lot of work. I spot clean as needed, like wherever he pees or poos, you know, I clean that up every couple of days. He doesn't pee in the tube, so those stay clean. And the DIY cage only needs to be a full clean, like probably, I don't know, like every 2 months or so. Because, again, you know, he just pees in the same little corner and I clean that out every couple days, so it's not like it gets dirty or anything. And it's the bigger the cage you have, the easier it is to clean, surprisingly. So yeah. And when I clean it, I have like this pink dustpan that I scoop all the bedding into, and I dump that out, and then it's just the solid floor of the cage with the contact paper, and I wipe that down with a wet rag with soap and water, and then I dry it. I let it air dry for maybe like 10 minutes or so, and then I put the fresh bedding back in. It's really easy. It's like the easiest cage I've ever cleaned. I can't stand the aquarium tanks I used to have because they were heavy. I had to pick them up, lug them in the bathroom, and this cage is just so much easier. And then his second question, what is your favorite hamster fur color and pattern? Oh, goodness. That's hard to say. Like, I like them all in their own way. I really liked Cream Puff's coloring. She was a dominant spot cream hamster, I think is what they called her. She looked white, like people thought she was white, but she actually wasn't. She was cream, and she had these darker cream spots on her that were really pretty. And obviously, I'm partial to black long-haired hamsters like Yodel and Baklava, because I think they're so cute. Tortoise shell, I think that's what they call them. Those hamsters, like, I've never seen in real life, and they are so pretty. I would love to have a tortoise shell one day. And, goodness, yeah, like I said, I like them all in their own way. So that was his questions. The next two are from BubblePop727. How do you decide if an object is punchy or not? Well, an object's always punchy if it's colorful and happy. The more colors, the better. And, I don't know, just like anything that's really colorful, rainbowy. I don't really know how to answer that question, sorry. Do you like taking pictures of people or hamsters better? Definitely hamsters. I cannot stand photographing people for the most part. It's just really awkward to tell people how to pose and whatnot. I don't mind photographing myself because that's different. It's just you set up the self timer and I'm really comfortable with that. But other people, like I've shot a few weddings before and that sort of thing is just stressful. So yeah, definitely hamsters, although hamsters are really tricky because they don't always do what you want them to. So yeah, I'm sure you guys all figured that out. Here is a question by, I'm not sure how to say your name, Isla I think that's how you say it. And she only asked one because she's cool like that. What is more fun to make, take? Photos or videos? I like them both in their own way, really. Like, they're totally different, so I can't compare them. Photographs are a lot less time consuming. Yodel! Yodel! Oh, goodness. But, like, I don't know, videos are cool too because obviously they show things in real time that you don't see in a photograph, so I like them both in their own way. Videos obviously take a whole lot longer to edit and put together than just photos do. So, yeah. Okay, here's one by the lovely Dame Abnormal. She asks, how long does it take you to do your awesome photo setups with your hammies? It usually takes quite a while. Yodel.
Hey. Hey. Why are you being so naughty, huh? Let's get out of there. Come on. Let's get out of here. No, you probably didn't want to be woken up, huh? And now you've got purple bedding all over you. Oh, what are we gonna do with Yodel? Huh? You're making a little mess. You're making a mess. That's okay. Yeah, I know. It's okay.
Alrighty.
Silly little dude.
What was I saying? Okay, so the question again, sorry about that. How long does it take you to do your awesome photo setups with your hammies? It does take a while to set it up, and typically I set up the lighting so that I don't have to use the flash and blind them. It just depends what I'm doing and how many props there are, but it does probably take me a couple hours from start to finish, you know, including sorting and editing, so I tend to not do it too often because it does take a long time. And then what's really frustrating, a lot of times you set it up and you get it all perfect and then you take the hamster out and they don't cooperate, so they just like run around wherever they want to. So then you don't end up with a photo anyway, so I've kind of given up in a way of doing like official photo shoots. Okay, and then she has another question. When you're in a pet store or online shopping for Yodely, what do you always tend to get him? I'm gonna sound like a really probably mean mommy, but I don't actually really buy him anything because I already have like all the supplies I need. You know, I just buy food and bedding pretty much, unless I see stuff at a thrift store, like that green igloo that you see in the playpen. Then, you know, like stuff that's really cheap, I buy it for him, but other than that, I really don't buy anything at pet stores anymore because I just don't need anything else. And I think he's spoiled enough and he probably doesn't really care, so. Okay. Love of Zeus, aka Llama, and she is so funny, by the way. As you guys know, she's like really funny, crazy, in a good way. How do you find all these yummy names for your hamsters? Well, first of all, I'm a huge dessert lover. I have a major sweet tooth, so. I have this like whole list that I made out of hamster names, and most of them are desserts. So whenever I adopt a new hamster, I look at that list and I try to find the name that I guess best suits their personality and you know, how they look and whatnot. Here's a little fact that you guys didn't know. When I got Yodel, there were two names that I was debating between. Yodel, obviously, and Moon Pie was the other one. There's these desserts called moon pies that are chocolate and they have this like white cream filling in them, but I don't know, it just didn't suit his personality. He's a lot more yodely than moon pie-y, I guess. so yeah, to make a long story short, I have a list of random dessert names that I pick for the hamsters, so. Okay. Do you like cheese? Yes, I love cheese. I like any kind of cheese, pretty much. I probably don't like it as much as Amaryllis's hamster Cinnabon does, though, because her hamster is, like, obsessed with cheese, so, yeah. Moving right along. Speaking of Amaryllis, she has a question for us. This is a really hard question, by the way. I bought a flying saucer, but Tess ignores it. How do you get yours to use them? Unfortunately, my answer will probably be pretty useless because I don't really have an answer to that. I've pretty much just stuck the flying saucer in the cage and the hamster just runs on it, so there's not really like any tricks that I've done. I have to say that I have, when I put it in Wonton's cage, he was the only hamster that like never used it, but all the other hamsters, yeah, they just, I don't know, they figure it out. Yodel had a little bit of a difficulty at first. He was sort of spinning it a little bit weird, but now he loves it. He runs on it every night, so goodness, I'm so sorry. If Tess chooses like not to run on it, then I guess she probably just doesn't like it. Being the spoiled little princess that she is, she probably has her little set wheel that she prefers or whatever, so. But yeah, you can always save the flying saucer and use it for, you know, other hamsters down the road. Some hamsters love them, and then other hamsters just will not use it at all. So, yeah, sorry. And I guess that's all the questions, it looks like. I'll probably be doing another video like this in the future, so if you do have questions, then feel free to ask them. And here's one question that I get asked a lot on my channel. People are saying, what video editor do you use? I use Avid Studio, and you can get a student discount if you have a school ID that you send in to them, and it's a lot cheaper than just buying at the manufacturer's pricing. So anyway, I will end this video now. I think it's long enough, and you're probably thoroughly bored, and Yodel looks like he's doing something in that little fish thing, so yeah, he wasn't really awake, but I had to do this because it was light out, so anyway, thank you for watching this, and I do have some really cool videos planned coming up in the future, so bye for now.